to yours. I would give you butterflies from my heart to yours.
We were so excited to welcome Laura Izibor. Everybody seems to be pronouncing her name wrong, and they corrected me, Izibor. So to help commemorate our one-year anniversary, we wanted to bring someone who was new, who was edgy, an artist that would kind of cross genres of music and bring in different crowds. So we achieved that goal. Tonight was really a celebration that we're here. We have had over 21,000 patrons come through the facility in the last year. So it's really a celebration for the community, for the city of Newport News, and for the staff here at the center.
The 22-year-old R&B singer from Dublin, Ireland, was recently named Rolling Stone's Artist to Watch. Her debut album is entitled Let Truth Be Told. And truth be told, this Irish singing sensation is hoping to make a splash here in the States, a big splash.
Laura, you accepted the invitation to come here. Why?
Oh, gladly. I mean, Ella Fitzgerald, huge icon, you know, and to be able to play in this theater is just amazing for me, you know, and it's such a lovely spot, Newport, Virginia. Anytime I went to Richmond last time, and it's just the whole area is always so warm and musical, so I relished in the opportunity to come back and you know, perform.
And the mark you want to leave on the music industry?
I just want to, you know, I don't look at it that way. I try to make music, honest music that I can be proud of and that I can be present in. And once I keep doing that and feel fulfilled and happy within, then that's, you know, that's all I think any artist can honestly hope for.
Oh, it was exciting. She's one of my favorite young artists, and I had to be here. I love the way that she sings, a combination of jazz and blues and folk, and she just mixed up everything that I like in music.
Great, she's phenomenal. Young woman that blows like that, great.
I'm speechless. It was so good. I love her music. I listen to her CD all the time. And my husband surprised me with birthday tickets to come down here to see her. And we just had a ball.
People may not know, but Ella Fitzgerald was born two blocks from the Downey Gross Cultural Arts Center. So when we were thinking of something really special for this building and a way to bring national recording artists and to bring stars, Ella Fitzgerald, she was the entertainer of the millennium, so we really worked hard to name the theater after her, and we always want to bring people who are Ella-like and worthy of being on the First Lady of Song stage.
It was a friend of mine that invited me to come out here. Didn't really know anything about it at the time, but I enjoyed it.
I really enjoyed the concert. It was wonderful. I'm so glad I was here up close and personal with her, and I want to get her autograph.
So you've been following her for a while?
Yes. I have her CD, and I'm in love with her. She is wonderful.
I'm from Richmond, and to come down here into a fine sun and then to see her, too, is just excellent.
She did a wonderful job, and I feel so good that we have such a wonderful performance that has come to our community. And of course, you can see from the applause that the citizens really loved and enjoyed her performance.
start bringing people into our community. We hear so much negative about it, and this is an awesome place where different people come, and we just need to get the word out more.
It's a jewel in the middle of the city. It's a jewel. It's cultural. They dance. They have all kind of educational stuff for kids.
You have to always come out and support whatever they have, whoever comes, because this is in our community. It's very important that we support the Don and Gross Cultural Arts Center.